Lots of people say that they want to be an indie game developer and make their own video games, but actually doing it is a bit more difficult than just talking about it. Hello, my name is Thornscale, and I decided to take up that challenge and become an indie game developer, and this is my first devlog. I've been watching a ton of tutorials, so many tutorials, and they've all had one thing in common. Start with small, crappy games. The sort of stuff you can make fast and toss up on itch.io for free. Don't start with your dream game. I thought that a game with a tutorial area, four stages, and a final boss fight counted as small when I started this, so that was the initial plan. Haha, nope. So anyway, I decided that I was going to start with a simple platformer in Unreal 5. I'll make another video later going over my thought process on picking Unreal 5, but the short version is blueprints and visual scripting. Not having to learn how to write code was like a dream come true. All right, on to the actual devlog. Day one. I focused on learning how to import a model, attaching animations to it, and also adding collision boxes and physics to actors. I did buy the golem off the marketplace, and if I'm going to be completely honest, I see myself using marketplace assets for a long time to come, because it's going to let me focus more on Unreal 5 than on Blender. Also, I've been messily tossing textures all over the place. And that was pretty much it for day one. I just wanted to kind of get some basics down and learn what I was doing. So then on to day two. I wanted to try and make some sort of damage system, so I grabbed an extra lava texture that came with the golem and stretched that bad boy across a square so I could play around with damage on hit stuff. And of course, death with a simple respawn system. And if we're gonna have a lava pool and death, we need something to fall off of. So moving platforms were called for, which introduced me to timeline nodes and these graphy looking things hidden within them. Pretty simple. One axis is distance moved and the other is duration of movement. Attach that to a set relative location node in the blueprints and movement is achieved. All right, day three, four, five. Honestly, I lost count. This thing was a mess. I wanted to add a collectible to the game, but I was having one huge problem. Since the pickup of objects was attached to the player's character, if the character died, it reset the counter. I was trying all sorts of stuff, including things that I was trying just because I didn't understand how they worked. None of the tutorials were giving me any of the answers that I was looking for. None of them showed me how to carry variables through death. And I was going bonkers trying to figure this out until DesthScyp pointed me in the right direction in the Ask Game Dev Discord server. The answer was game instance, which I had no idea even existed before then. Heck, even when they were initially describing it to me, I thought they were just talking about the character blueprint or something. But once I saw their video that explained how you could toss variables over to it and then pull them back, it became clear that yes, this was the answer to all my problems. Honestly, getting that figured out felt like it unlocked in my head just how all of this worked. It was like a huge light bulb went off. I loved it. It just made everything click for me. Day six-ish. At this point, I figured I had enough mechanics worked out that it was time to actually start creating the first stage after a player leaves the tutorial area, because I thought the tutorial area was still going to be a thing at this point. I decided I wanted it to be a beach, something bright and vibrant to contrast with the cave I had planned for the tutorial. At one point, I was thinking I'd have swimming, but realized that was probably a dumb idea considering the fact that I don't know enough to make swimming work, and the fact that the golem should, in theory, sink like a rock anyway. So at this point, I decided I just need to make some coral barriers to keep the player from just walking off the edge of the world. The ocean itself is using the official water plugin. After that came a volcano to house that lava from the practice map, but with a little bit of tweaking, making it something a bit better, I grabbed a nice looking animated lava off the marketplace and promptly ripped it apart and dissected its blueprints to see how it moved and how it animated. And I was then able to change that and apply it to a big square that I then dropped into the volcano. And that became the lava. Day 7, 8, and 9-ish. Speed! Kinda! Just making the golem run really fast looked ridiculously janky, as he jittered all over the place. So instead, I decided to take a page out of Sonic's book and have him roll up into a boulder and roll around. Initially, I was going to do this by having the model itself roll up into a ball, but that just wasn't working. It it looked really bad. It was not moving around the way I wanted it to. So I decided to swap him out with a ball. I tried just swapping out the mesh, but all that did was just drop a ball on the ground, so that didn't work. So what I ended up doing was completely a cheat. I added a sphere mesh to the player character, and when the player pressed the sprint button, the goal mesh shrunk and the sphere mesh grew, appearing to swap out. But I couldn't find any way to make the sphere move, it seemed static. I couldn't figure out how to apply physics to it, so I double cheated and grabbed the material movement blueprint I learned from the lava and applied that to the sphere, but just really, really fast. So now, while the sphere itself doesn't technically spin, the movement of the material makes it appear to spin. Problem solved. And all I had to do was change up the sprint code so it only activated when both the sprint key and the forward button were pressed. Otherwise, the sphere would appear to just kind of spin in place if only the sprint button were pushed by itself. I also created an area where I wanted a specific AI fight to occur in the future, but the geometry of the area is completely screwed. So that's not going to survive another day. I also changed the path up to the volcano because I figured there's going to be plenty of jumping to be had elsewhere, and it might be fun for players to go zipping down the ramps. And to the right of the volcano, I cleared out an area for some ruins and related pillar jumping puzzles. Day 10-ish. I keep speeding up the boulder form each time I mess with it, and it's because going zippy fast is super fun. I'll probably still make it faster before I'm done. The main thing I did, though, was to add more foliage to the forest ruins area, and that was kind of a mistake. The frame rate in that area has dropped down to single digits. I know that some of the trees have just too much going on, and I tried to give them the nanite treatment, which I just kind of assumed is a miracle cure-all for complex shapes. But I'm realizing now that really I just need to research what Unreal's nanite system is actually used for, so maybe I can use it a bit better and actually save some FPS. I also scattered a few crystals around just for the heck of it, and modified my floating platforms in the lava to move vertically, potentially dropping slow players into a lava-filled death. And that's pretty much where I am now. I have a laggy forest I need to optimize, a bunch of unfinished jumping puzzles, and no AI yet. Which led me to one big conclusion. I need to pull way back on the initial scope of my game so that I can move on to my next simple game and continue learning. And if you'd like to follow me in this process, please hit the like and subscribe buttons. And if you're a game dev yourself, please, please, please feel free to drop your suggestions down in the comments below. Just make them noob friendly because I really am just getting started. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.